And welcome to our channel Dawn of Chemistry. I have made some videos on the physical chemistry part and on the inorganic part also. So far I didn't do any video on the organic part. So I am starting a video from the organic part and let us start the topic IUPAC nomenclature. This is the major confusing part and every student will be struggling how to write the IUPAC nomenclature of the compounds. Let us see. Organic chemistry. Why I am putting organic chemistry is even in inorganic chemistry complex compounds also we are having this IUPAC nomenclature. To avoid the confusion, I am mentioning it. IUPAC nomenclature. We know very well what is IUPAC means. International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry. This is the council which decides some rules to name the organic compounds. If it is inorganic chemistry means we can have some limited number of compounds, but organic chemistry is not like that. Day by day millions and millions of compounds is being synthesized, so it is becoming enormous and it is very difficult for even any human being to remember all those names. So that's why they have proposed some systematic nomenclature, that is nothing but the IUPAC nomenclature. According to this IUPAC nomenclature, some set of rules are there. If you understand the rules properly means you can easily name any compound they give you. Majorly students will be facing so many troubles in writing IUPAC name itself. If you take mains, NEET exam, advanced exam and local entrance test examinations are there, you can have one question which is that. You can get one question in any entrance test. Let us get into the details how to write IUPAC name of a compound. See, every IUPAC name majorly contains the five components. If you understand what are these five components and how to write those five components means you can do any problem on the nomenclature in fraction of seconds only. See, every IUPAC name contains majorly five parts. If you take any IUPAC name, that will contain five parts. What are the five parts means? Root word, primary suffix, secondary suffix, primary prefix, secondary prefix. Why I have written in this order means in the same order every IUPAC name will be present. Secondary suffix, primary suffix, root word, primary prefix, secondary prefix. What are these things means? Let me explain you this with an example. Let us take this compound. For this IUPAC nomenclature means I will tell you how to write those things. Let me give you a brief idea on what are these components based on this example. The name of this compound is four methyl साइक्लो फोर मिथाइल साइक्लो हेक्स टू इन वन मोल. दिस इज द आईयूपीएसी नॉर्म ऑफ इट. फोर मिथाइल साइक्लो हेक्स टू इन वन मोल विल बी कमिंग. व्हाट आर दिस कंपोनेंट्स इन दिस मीन्स हेक्स हेक्स टू इन वन मोल साइक्लो फोर मिथाइल. यू कैन क्लासिफाई दिस इन टू दिस थिंग. इफ यू सी द रूट वर्ड, हेक्स इज ए रूट वर्ड, टू इन इज ए प्राइमरी सफिक्स, वन मोल इज ए सेकेंडरी सफिक्स, दिस इज ए primary prefix and this one is a secondary prefix will be coming. So now let us see what are these components and what they are going to explain about. Always remember, a root word explains about number of carbon atoms in main chain. Always remember, root word gives idea about the number of carbon atoms present in the main chain. Primary suffix gives idea about whether it is having single bond, whether it is having double bond, whether it is having triple bond in its structure. We can explain by using the primary suffix. Whether the compound is having single bond in its structure or double bond in its structure or triple bond in its structure can be easily understood by using primary suffix. And you see this one, primary prefix. This primary prefix will give idea about whether the compound is cyclo compound, bicyclo compound or spiro compound. It will give idea about whether the compound is cyclo compound, bicyclo compound, spiro compound or open chain compound. That is given idea by using the primary prefix. And let us see secondary suffix and secondary prefix. What are these secondary suffix and secondary prefixes means? Secondary suffix gives idea about the functional group present in the compound. Secondary suffix gives idea about the functional group present in the compound. I will explain you when I was explaining the each and everything separately. Secondary prefix gives idea about the substituents. Secondary suffix, secondary prefix, prefix. Pre means before fixed, which is fixed before root word is a prefix, which is fixed after root word is a suffix. So like this, every IUPAC name, you take any IUPAC name, you have to see that in these five components, then only you can do the problem very easily. So if you take anything, so if you click any compound IUPAC name, try to see that in these parameters easily you can solve the problem. Let us see this one name. I told you root word. Root word is hex, which indicates six carbon atoms present in this one. I will explain root word and all what are the things. Secondary suffix 2 in indicates a double bond is present on the second position. One mole indicates one hydroxy group is present on the first position. Cyclo indicates the compound is a cyclic compound. Four methyl indicates a methyl substituent is present on the fourth position. Like that, by looking at the structure or by looking at the IUPAC name, once you can break that into these things, means immediately you can identify the IUPAC name of any compound. Let them give you an IUPAC name of half board also, if you can classify it properly, you can easily name that particular compound. Right. So this IUPAC nomenclature video I am going to make in three parts. In the first part, I will explain what is a root word, what is a primary suffix, what is a primary prefix. In the second part, I will explain what is the secondary suffix and what is secondary prefix. What are the rules to give the numbering for the compound? In the third part, I will explain you what are the different compounds, examples, and how to name those things. Mostly in three parts, I am going to explain this IUPAC nomenclature. Have a glance look on this thing. Hope you have taken this thing. Let us get into the details of each and everything. Let us just see the first and foremost thing, root word. Root means basic thing, the basis. Without this you can't see any organic compound name. That's why we call it as a root word, which gives idea about the number of carbon atoms present in main chain. This is a very very important thing. First you should know what is main chain and how to identify main chain. What are the properties of a main chain? If you don't know how to identify main chain, means you can't do anything. Let us see what are the properties of main chain. The first one is main chain will have high priority functional group. Main chain will have high priority functional group. What is this high priority functional group means? In the second part I will explain, but for the time being you just remember this statement. Anyhow, we are going to do problems after completion of these things. Main chain will have high priority functional group. Main chain will have maximum carbon atoms. Maximum carbon atom, the first priority you have to give for the main chain, main functional group. After that main functional group, you have to give priority for the maximum carbon atoms. If carbon atoms are same, then you should go for main chain should have more substituents. So these are the three rules you have to follow during identifying the main chain. So let them give you any compound. First you have to see for the main functional group or high priority functional group. After identifying high priority functional group, then only you have to see whether it is having maximum carbon atoms are there or not. After finding maximum carbon atoms, then you have to come to the maximum substituents. Let me tell you some examples. CH3, CH2, 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 CHO, CH2, 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 CH3. COOH. This is one thing. CH2, CH3. Now you see, these are the things we are having. So what should be the main chain? The first thing you have to see for is maximum priority functional group. So definitely main chain should have maximum priority functional group. See, see here. This is one main chain you can have. This is one main chain you can have. This is the second main chain. And one more main chain you can have is this one. So red color is one main chain. Second one, black one is one main chain and blue one is another main chain. So what we have to select as a main chain means the first rule is main chain should have high priority functional group among carboxylic acid and then CHO. Definitely COOH is the high priority functional group. I will explain that in a further classes. So COOH is the main functional group. So main chain definitely should have COOH. So that's why third one is not possible, since third one is having CHO. So we can't consider this. Next, move to this one. If you take this thing, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 carbon atoms are there. So though it is a functional group, but we have to go for the maximum carbon atom. So that's why this is having 6 carbon atoms. Since it is having 6 carbon atoms, it is not possible. Since it is having 8 carbon atoms, which is the main chain, means second one is the main chain. Like this, you have to identify what is a main chain. So for the first one, second one is a main chain. Even though main functional group thing is having minimum carbon atoms, that only we have to take as a main chain. Remember this very carefully. Even though that is having the less number of carbon atoms, that should be main chain. Let me tell you this example. CHO, CH2, 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 CHO, CH2, 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 CH3, CH3. If you see this thing, CH2, CH3. Here, this will be the main chain. Why this will be the main chain means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are there. So, two functional groups of same type is there. When same type functional groups are present, you can't decide which gets the first priority or which should take and which should eliminate. That time you have to consider both into the main chain. So, that's why 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 are there. Though it is having 7 carbon atoms, it can never come into the main chain. This is the exceptional case. That's why I am telling you a main chain should satisfy the very first point is it should have high priority functional group. When there is no high priority functional group, then you have to go to the maximum carbon atoms. When it is present and that is with possible carbon atoms are minimum. If maximum carbons are possible means you have to go to the maximum carbons only. If there is no chance means then you have to adjust with minimum carbons only. So high priority functional group. Main chain should have maximum carbon atoms. If you see this one, you can have, this is one main chain. The possibility main chains I am writing here. This is another main chain and one more main chain we are having is this one. So maximum carbon atoms to be present. First you take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbons are there. Second one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 carbon atoms are there. And you see this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 carbons are there. So which is main chain means the one with 9 carbon atoms is main chain. So it is a nonane will come. Here this will be octane will come. With respect to only root word and all substituent and all I am not mentioning. This case you see, after finding carbon atoms, maximum carbon atoms, if carbon atoms are coming same, if carbon atoms are coming same, then you have to see the one which is having maximum substituent. So let us see in this case, you can have, this is a main chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are there. And another main chain you are having is this one, वन दिस वन दैट इज वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव मेन चेन इज देयर दिस इज हैविंग फाइव दिस इज हैविंग फाइव वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव दिस इज हैविंग मेन चेन फाइव नाउ विच शुड बी गिवन फर्स्ट प्रायोरिटी मीन्स सी first, second, third. So, which will be given first priority means C. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons are there. How many substituents? 1, 2, 3 substituents are there. 5 carbons with 3 substituents. See this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons with 1 substituents. This one you see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons with 3 substituents are there. So, which should be given first priority means if you take this chain or this chain, both will be same only. So, that's why this will be given first priority. This or this, both naming will be coming. Like that, you have to see. Though it is having same carbon atoms, you have to see for a main chain having the maximum carbon atoms. Like this, we have to identify the main chain in the open compounds. In the open compounds, you have to see the main chain. Right. Have a glance look on this. Next, let us move to the other rules. This is for open chain compounds. If it is chain compounds, that is cyclic compounds. Cyclic compounds. When cyclic compounds are there, the one with max carbons is main chain. The one with maximum carbons is main chain. Here it is there. This will become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons are there. This is having 4 carbons, which is main chain means 5 carbons, one is the main chain. The one with maximum carbons is main chain. Take this one means this is 6 carbons are there, this is 3 are there, which is main chain means this one will be main chain. If number of carbon atoms is same, cyclic is main chain. If number of carbon atoms is same means cyclic will be main chain. If you take this one, which will be the main chain means cyclic will be the main chain. This is 6 carbons, this is 6 carbons, and the cyclic one will be the main chain. If number of carbon atoms is the same, cyclic is a main chain. If the one with substituent or the one with high priority functional group is a main chain. The one with high priority functional group is main chain irrespective of carbon atoms. The one with main functional group is the main chain irrespective of number of carbon atoms. So if you take this one, OH is there. This is 3 carbons, 7 carbons, which is main chain means 3 carbons is a main chain. Like this, we can identify main chain in the cyclic compounds. So main chain means always open chain compounds, means these are the rules. Main chain should have high priority functional group, it should have maximum carbon atoms, main chain should have maximum substituents. In this case, cyclic compounds, maximum carbons is the main chain, number of carbon atoms is same, cyclic is main chain, the one with high priority functional group is main chain. Both will be same rules only. Here when same carbons are there, we will go for the one with maximum substituents. Here we will go for the one with cyclic thing into the main chain. Like this we can identify. This is how we can identify for the cyclic compounds. Hope you have taken this. Let us see for aromatic compounds, which will be the main chain. Aromatic compounds. For aromatic compounds, always benzene is main chain. We are not going to the heterocyclic compounds. Our limit ends up to this one only. Aromatic with benzene only, our limit will stop. That's why I am stopping here. For fused bicyclics are there, I will take a separate session for that thing. Always benzene is main chain for alkyl substituents. Always benzene is main chain for alkyl substituent. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are there. So it will be nonyl benzene. This is what we will write. So for benzene, its main chain will be always benzene only. If any functional group is there, side chain, then it will be main chain. If any functional group is on the side chain, then it will be main chain. OH is present means this will be the main chain. So it will become 1, 2, 3. So it will become 3-phenyl propane 2-ol will come. So 3-phenyl propane 2-ol will come. Like this we can study about the, if both are having functional groups, means the one with highest priority functional group will be main chain. If you take this one CHO OH, now this will become the main chain. So it will be 2 will come, 1, 2, 3. So you can take 2 hydroxy propyl benzaldehyde. Like this we can write the compound. So like this, whenever open chain compounds are there, how to choose the main chain. Whenever cyclic compounds are there, how to choose the main chain. Whenever aromatic compounds are there, how to choose the main chain. Like this we can identify how to choose main chain. After choosing main chain, writing the root word. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, it continues, 20, 30, 40, it continues. So how to name these things, what are the root words means, see, myth, eth, prop, bute, pent, hex, hep, op, known, deck, and deck. See, deck is there, 10 will come. And deck means 1 we call it as un, and deck we will continue. 2 is there means bi-deck. 3 means tri-deck, tetra-deck, pentadeck, hexadeck, heptadeck, octadeck, nonadeck will come. 20 is there means icosa. 21 means anicosa will come. 22 means bi-icosa will come. 30 is there means tricont will come. 40 is there means tetracont will come. Like that it will be going. 50 is there means pentacont will come. Like that, based on the number of carbon atoms, we will write the root word. With this thing, we can close the root word chapter. So, root word means it mainly gives idea about the number of carbon atoms present in the main chain. How to identify the main chain means, for open compounds, how to identify main chain. For cyclic compounds, how to identify main chain. And for aromatic compounds, how to identify main chain. After finding what is a main chain, and these are the things. Main chain is having one carbon atom means we will write mith. In presence of root word, simply we will write mith. Two are there means it. Prop, but, pent, hex, hept, oct, non, dec. 11 is there means undec. 12 is there means bidec. Like that it continues. 20 is there means icosa will come. 21 is there means anicosa will come. Bi-icosa, tri-icosa will come. 30 means tricont will come. 40, tetracont will come. Like this we can write the root word. Like that you can take any compounds. You can take any type of compound and you can practice writing the root word. You will become strong in that thing. As many problems as you practice, that much you will become strong in this case. Have a look on these things. Hope you have gone through these things. Let us move to the next thing. Primary suffix. What is this primary suffix and how to write the primary suffix? Primary suffix gives idea about whether compound is having any double or triple bonds. It gives idea about whether compound is having any double bond or triple bond. If there is any double bond, we will use it as ene. If there is any double bond, we will use it as ene. If there is any triple bond, we will use it as ine. The position is mentioned. Among double and triple bonds, triple bond gets the first priority, double bond gets the second priority. Double bond gets the second priority, triple bond gets the first priority. On terminal positions, if both are present means double bond gets the first priority, triple bond gets the second priority during numbering. Let us see, for example, so these are the different compounds we are having. So how to name these compounds means, see, see root word 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Root word is hex, plus double bond is present means ene will come. Hex plus ene will come. On first position is there, so it will be 1-hexene will be coming. This one you see, double bond and triple bond are there means you have to give numbering from the double bond side. So that's why 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It will be hept 2 in, 5 I will come. In this case, double bond and triple bond are terminal, means double bond gets the first priority. So it will become hex 1 in, 5 I will come. In this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 will come. In this case, hex 1 in, 3 in will come. Like this, we can give the priority. Whether a compound is having double bond or triple bond is explained by the primary suffix. If no double bond or no triple bond, simply single bond is there, means we will use the suffix in we will be using. Like this, you can name any compound with is with simple structures. So this is the thing. Among the double bond and triple bond, double bond gets the first priority, triple bond gets the second priority during numbering. Here I am just giving you idea on the numbering, so you can have idea on that thing. That's why I am mentioning numbering. I will take a separate session and there I will explain. Here you see, when they are on the terminal positions, triple bond gets the first priority, this gets the second priority. If both are in terminal, means double bond gets the first priority. So be careful with this thing. So primary suffix simply gives idea about the whether it is having any double bond or triple bond. Let us move to the primary prefix. This is very important one. Primary prefix. What is this primary prefix and how to name the compounds by using this primary prefix, and how to write this primary prefix? Primary prefix gives idea about whether the compound is open chain compound or whether it is a cyclo compound, whether it is bicyclo compound, or whether it is a spiro compound. What is the cyclo compound means? If the compound is having cyclic structure, then we call it as a cyclo compound. So if it is with closed rings, means then we name it as a cyclo. If it is open chain, means then we call it as a open chain, and there will be no secondary primary prefix. There will be no primary prefix for the open chain compounds. For cyclo compounds, we will use the cyclo. Bicyclo and spiro, you see. Bicyclo compounds contain two cycles which are connected with two carbon atoms. Bicyclo compounds means compounds in which the two cycles are connected with two carbon atoms are known as a bicyclo compounds. Two cyclic rings connected with two carbon atoms. So compounds in which there are two ring structures are there and they are connected with one another with two carbon atoms, then they are known as the bicyclo compounds. Spiro compounds means compounds which contain two cyclic compounds and they connect with one another with same carbon atom or single carbon atom. They are known as a bicyclo spiro compounds. Two cycles with same carbon, they are known as a spiro compounds. Don't confuse with fused aromatic compounds. Fused aromatic compounds is a different category. These things are a different category. This primary prefix has nothing to do with the aromatic fused compounds like naphthalene is there, anthracene is there, phenanthrene is present, those things, imidazole is present, those and all has no relation with this primary prefix. So like this, we can study about this UPSC nomenclature, what is root word, what is primary prefix, and what is primary suffix and all. That is with this class, I will be closing the things. If you are new to this video channel, means subscribe to the channel and click bell icon for the more updates from my channel. Like this video, so it will be definitely helpful for some other people also. Please share this video. Thank you.